All right, so we're gonna install this stuff on here. First, we're gonna take the plate, make sure the little these pieces are on the outside. The spacer, open and down. So you notice how you've got the wires right here. We're gonna put this top piece right here with the opening right there to where it's gonna be facing down, because this will be in the 2 o'clock position, like I said. Then we're gonna put our nuts on, washers and nuts, where I got the washers there. All right, so now you gotta make sure the wood drift's in there. Gonna be a little bit of a pain in the butt. But you're gonna stick this on here. Notice that's solid round. Well, the inside of that fan is not. So make sure you stick this piece to where it's up. I got the wood drift stuff popping up. Bottomed out. Let's say you start out with 2 or 3 shims. Put the fan on. Already sounds like I'm gonna need more shims. So I haven't even tightened it down, you can hear it revving. So I'm gonna go ahead and find another shim off the old one. All right, so I've got my shim issue fixed out, or fixed. So now we're gonna put on our washer. And then our nut. The nut is gonna be torqued to 43 foot-pounds. Yeah, definitely make sure everything's good to go. And nothing's rubbing before you torque it down completely, but 43 foot-pounds. Let me get my torque wrench. All right, so now we're gonna test fit the generator alternator in the doghouse. I still need to get the actual hardware, but for right now, I'm gonna use the sheet metal screws. But right off the bat, you should not hear anything rubbing when it's tightened on the fan. I might have to put additional shims on there to help it not rub. All right, so we got the screws temporarily installed. I'm gonna go ahead and keep going, but you can see back here, there's a little bit of room. So if you needed to use more shims, you could, to keep it from rubbing. So there's, you know, more room to play with. All right, so I got my alternator installed in the doghouse. Now I'm gonna put the doghouse onto the engine very carefully to make sure that I don't damage anything. Oh, wrong hole. You also don't want to mess up your doghouse. What am I caught on? Generator on there. All right, here we go. Gotta reposition. It's in this side, not in this. All right, you just want to make sure it's kind of flush. Those will push in and be gentle, but if you needed to, you could use a screwdriver to kind of, well, yep, I'll need to pull that away to let that fall down. But yeah, there you go. That's it for that part. All right, so got it on there. Kind of got to finagle some stuff. Make sure all the sheet metal tin's not hitting the engine block funny and this, that, and the other. But also, too, you obviously want your alternator generator to be flush with the stand. Once it's there, you know, I've put these screws in here just a little bit, but I haven't tightened them down. I doubt it's going to really go anywhere. But just, you know, tighten this sucker down first. And then just make sure that you've got it on that little ledge. and then start tightening. Don't, obviously if you tighten it down where I've got it right now, it ain't gonna do anything. All right, so I've got the clamp tightened down. You don't have to get crazy with it, but this thing should not move independently with the engine. So if you got any questions, obviously I'm gonna tighten these screws up. I got a little bit of an interesting gap going on, so that sucks, but this side's all right. If you got any questions, just let me know. If you like the video, please click the like button and subscribe. Thanks.